Hello everyone, and welcome to another mkdev video. Today, we're going to talk about containers. Really, we're going to talk about containers in AWS, and more specifically about ECS Fargate. AWS has two ways to use containers: EKS with Kubernetes, with or without Fargate, and ECS with Docker or Firecracker. In our example today, we're going to execute an Spring Boot application in a Fargate task, and we're going to explain how to do that step by step. Our Java code will be a simple web server, everything connected to Route 53 and a load balancer. Let's start. If we execute directly rather boot run, it's going to download all the needed dependencies to build the application and run it. After that, the web server will start in the port 8080. Now that the application is up and running, we only need to go to a browser and check that everything is okay. So to do that, it will go to a different console and we execute curl minus vvv http 127.0.0.1.8080, and then we put slash greetings. So with no parameters, what we can see is the result that first we're going to see that there is an ID one. We'll talk about that later on when we start several tasks, and then the content with the hello world. What we're going to do now is pass a parameter to our application. So if we execute curl minus minus v http 127.0.0.1:8080/greeting, and now we put question mark name for somebody called Peter. What we'll see is that now we have the ID too, because it's the second execution, and now we are going to have, in this case, the name Peter. Simple. Let's create the jar file. To do that, let's execute gradle build. Okay, so the idea here is that the jar file, as soon as it's built, will be injected in the Docker file. In other video, we'll see how to do that connected with a Jenkins pipeline. But today, we'll see something more simple. In our Docker file, we're going to use OpenJDK as a base image. And after that, we're going to copy the file directly and execute java-r. That's all. No versions, no variables, no tags. Today is time to talk about Fargate, so we will speed up this part. Now, we build our Docker image. When this step is done, we will move our image to AWS CDR. To do that, we first need to set up our AWS credentials. This is up to you. And after that, we need to set up the connection between our Docker in a Linux, in our Linux machine, and ECS. The magical command that is doing that is AWS ECR get login. When we execute this command, what we need to do now is we need to get the output, and we only need to remove this minus e none that you see at the end of the token, copy the command, this Docker login, and execute it. And after that, we will be connected to ECR. We start to move in AWS. First thing that we must do is create a repository in CDR. To do that, we go to CDR, get started, and press in create repository, simple. Add the name of our repository, web server in our case, and that's all. If we press in the top right corner, in the bottom view push commands, we will see what next steps are. First, we need to tag the image with the Docker tag. So we will go copy the command, and after that we will go to our console and we paste the command with the Docker tag command. When this is done, we need to go back again to our browser, copy the Docker push command that we have, and what we're going to do is we're going to push this command. You will see that in our case we are not changing the tags, we are directly using latest. After the image is pushed, you can press in web service and then check the URI of the image that has been pushed. Let's move to EC2, because now we need to create a load balancer. In our case, will be an application load balancer. The idea is that we will be connected to the load balancer in the port 80 in our case, and this will be forward the connection to the target group in the port 8080 in case that the connection is healthy. We'll see that how it's working later on. What we need to create a load balancer? We need a name. For us, web service. For us too, it's going to be internet facing because we need to connect outside to inside. And we're going to leave the port 80. We are going to allow our free availability sums too. If we move to security groups, we need to do a little chain. We need to allow connections to the port 8080. Because we want to reuse the security group later. Let's create the target group. We add the name. In our case, we have service, as always. We change the target type to IP, the protocol, in this case, to 8080, and path to greeting. This is the path in the URL that will return the code 200 that will give healthy our target group. After that, everything is done, and we only need to press and create. Next step, create our Fargate cluster. Something super simple. ECS with EC2 needs EC2 instances, but in our case, it's going to be a network cluster only. We go to ECS cluster, create cluster, and choose network cluster. Super simple. Only choose a name and connect to CloudWatch, and as soon as we press, the cluster is created. This is our cluster, nothing else. If we go to EC2 instances, we will see that there is nothing. And this is the magic here. We don't control the instances. AWS, we will do that. Now, let's go to create the task definition. Here, we are going to define the resources of our task, CPU, memory, and the containers that we want to have, with the images, environment variables, etc. In our case, it's going to be Fargate. We choose the name, web service, to have a common name. Choose the task role. This is where we connect AIM and Fargate. We're going to choose ECS task execution role. In case that, for example, we need to use an S3, we will have to create new rules for this role, or we can create a new role. After that, next step is choose the memory and CPU for our task. We will choose 0.5 gigs and 0.25 virtual CPUs. At the container, in this window, we need to choose the name of our container and the image name. To get this image name, we need to go back to the CDR, if you remember, and then we need to choose the image that we create and then copy the URI in the container image in the ECS. Last step in our case is add the port 88 in the container mapping. With that, we are going to allow the connection to our task in the port 8080, same port that in the application is going to be open. And that's all. Now we can add the container and create the task definition. After the task definition is created, we need to go to the cluster and create a service. This is the way to interconnect the task definition and our cluster. When we press create, we only need to choose in Fargate, choose our task definition and the revision that we want to use. This is the first one, so in our case will be one. Only add the service name and choose our number of tasks to start in the service. We will choose one here, and later we will play a bit. In the second window, we need to choose the VPC and the subnets that we want to use. We will choose our three subnets. In the security group, we're going to reuse the same security group that we create in the load balancer step. If you remember, it was open for the ports 80 and 88. Next step is in the load balancer. Let's use our previous created application load balancer, the one that it was connected to the target group that we created before. Next step is super interesting, because now we are going to connect the load balancer with the port in the container with the target group. In the container to load balancer, we need to press add load balancer and now connect our port 80 in the load balancer with the port 8080 in the target group. It's simple. Last step is create the service discovery integration. This functionality is going to be able to create an entry in Route 53 DNS every time that we create a new container. This is needed in ECS when you want to talk between services, unless you go out to the load balancer, but you know, in our case, this is an internet-faced load balancer. Our namespace is going to be called webservice.local, and as soon as the task is created, this will be called webservice.webservice.local. Next step, and save. This is going to take a while, but if we go to AWS Cloud Map, we can see the domain has been created. As soon as the container is created, there will be an entry inside the domain. But now, if we go to the Route 53, we can see that the domain. And inside the domain, we see the entry and the IP that we have in this case. This IP will appear as soon as it's approved in the target group. But how this is working? If we go to the load balancer, and after that to the listeners, the listener to the port 80, we will have the answer. The idea is that the connection goes through the load balancer, and if one of the rules is a match, for example, like in our case, because the path is the one that we want to go, then the connection will forward to the target group and then to the container. We add a new rule in the path greeting to go to the target group web service. If we go to the target group web service, we can see that it's listening in the port 8080. And in the targets, we will see that our task is healthy because it has passed the health check. If we go back to the load balancer and we copy the DNS name that we had before, we are going to use this name in our test. Now, if we copy this address in our browser and we do incur ker-vvv, http, and the URL / greeting, so we are going to see the output. But if we see that, something strange is going to happen. Why the ID is not one as before? This is simple. You know, our target group is testing the URL. And every time that this testing is happening, the number is increasing. So you can see that now it's happening 15 times. Okay, really 14 times before. Now, let's test our ECS. We're going to jump from one ECS task to 5. To do that, we need to go back to ECS, and we are going to change the service, not the task definition. And as soon as we are there, we need to click in update. We go to the number of tasks, and we change to 5. Now, we click in the next steps, blah, blah, and at the end, we approve, and that's all. Now we only have to wait a while. Now we can see a big difference between ECS and Kubernetes. Kubernetes creates an object called service in front of the pod to get visibility, while ECS is not working in this way. With ECS, we need to go to the load balancer. In our case, it's an internet phase to later on go inside. For sure that this is not a normal case, but okay, we are using internet phase. Now, where are the logs? In CloudWatch. We can go directly to CloudWatch and search by ECS, for example, web service. Or we can go to the task, open the container, and at the end of the page, we can see a link to CloudWatch. Because we have 5 tasks, there will be 5 entries in CloudWatch. We're ready. We can test with 5 tasks. Because we're using round robin, the health check is going to increase the ID differently per task. And because we still have the old task, we're going to see different IDs every time that we connect to our application. So you can play with it and you can change it, for example, the ID with the host name, and you can do many things. Remember that this is not Kubernetes. This is ECS serverless. And it's working fine, you know, for the case that we have seen. And even the price that we pay for that is not too much. If we compare between ECS with EC2 or ECS with Fargate, my recommendation is use Fargate. Because at the end, we don't need to administrate any EC2 instance, EBS, etc. What problems do we have? At the time that we record this video, you cannot connect your task to EFS, for example. And in your task, not your container, your task needs to have a serve physical volume is going to be a problem. You can serve with containers in the same task for kicks, but not in the other way. And for example, something else. In the services, you can change, for example, a variable, an environment variable that you have defined in the task definition. And this is a problem too. And something that is simple to do in a task. But okay, I think that this will change and this will be improved to my next versions. So that's all. I hope you enjoyed the video and the explanation. And if you have any question, please leave a comment and we will answer you. So thank you and see you next time.